Rusangu University, formerly known as Zambia Adventist University, is a private co-educational Christian university based in Rusangu Mission in Monze District, Zambia. It is owned and operated by the Seventh-day Adventist Church.
A university has for its primary purpose providing quality academic programs. One of the things that has to be done in order to provide quality academic programs is one has to have qualified faculty. Now, when you teach a bachelor's degree, when you offer bachelor's degree level, you have to have all your lecturers, with no exception, who will teach for bachelor's degree level, be at least with the minimum of a master's degree in related fields that they are teaching. If you offer graduate work, which is master's degree, which Rusangu University does, we have 13 master's degree programs. Again, if you are going to offer master's degree programs or PhD programs, then you need to have relevant qualified faculty in related programs that you are going to be offering.
Rusangu is an institution of higher learning that offers programs rich in traditional Christian academics and values.
Zambia as a country has been crying for having morally governed and directed leaders. People who are not just good in decision making or in financial analysis, but people who have integrity, people who are honest, people who value homes, proper homes. One of our strategic intent is to increase the spirituality of our students, the spirituality of our faculty and staff, and lead exemplary Christian lives. It doesn't help us to develop academically great minds, but who are only smart thieves. It doesn't help us to have all these things we can produce mentally, but then be morally bankrupt. So we are actually very strong on moral development. We tell our students, they attend what we call convocations. During convocation, we speak about the moral life of a great leader. I was also going to actually mention that along this line, we have also embraced the partnership with government to clean Zambia, keep Zambia clean. So we've set out 2 days in a quarter when we will ground our toes, remove our neckties, and put on jeans, and go and collect garbage and clean our environment. So those are some of the things we are doing, and we're glad that we can be partners in Zambia with other institutions and government in developing this nation that we love so much.
Other than the main campus in Monze District, the university also has a presence in Zambia's capital city, Lusaka, and on the Copper Belt in Kitwe. The university traces its historical roots in the missionary endeavors of an American missionary named William Harry Anderson.
The vision that began a long, long time ago in 1903, when there was more bush and forest than open ground. That vision, which has lived on, which has taken different turns, sometimes appearing like we were going back, that vision lives on. And it's for that reason that we are seated here this morning. If Anderson, who came in 1903, coming to see Chief Monze to ask for a piece of land where they could develop something. If Anderson would come back to life and be one of us this morning, seated here, he probably would not believe that this is the same Rusango that was given to him in 1903.
To this day, the beacon erected in the early 1900s by Anderson after he was given the land is still standing despite the surroundings having significantly changed with time.
To God be the glory, great things He has done. So loved He the world that He gave us His Son, who yielded His life an atonement for sin, and opened the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give Him the glory, great things He has done.
Over the years, Rusangu University has grown, not only in size, but in student numbers. Starting with an initial student number of 46 in 2003, the institution now boasts of about 4,000 students.
We are appealing to the general public out there that Rusangu University is among the universities that you could consider for your child. You could consider for your ward, you could consider for any relative that you want to receive university education, because our fees are very, very affordable, and we also offer terms that are user-friendly, terms that enable people to pay for their education. Rusangu University is the place to be.
Further, the institution of higher learning has continued to evolve to remain relevant to the needs of ever-changing world.
We have two major researches that we have harnessed. We have already begun and we have taken off. Number one, it's on geoscience. We have established a geoscience office for the region of Southern Africa. We are actually, as best as we know, with the research we're going to do, we are probably the only ones on the continent that are doing that. That research will look at the relationship that we find in the geological area of, it's a study of stones, rocks, soil construction, soil composition, in relationship to the flood of Noah. This research will attempt to start exploring. Do we have evidences, for example, through the study of rock formation, stratas of soils, do we have evidence of the flood of Noah? And obviously, anything that is related to geology. We have partnered with Loma Linda University, a sister university based in California. And obviously, being a younger institution, we have professors from there who will be engaged. They've already been here. They've set up the office. So that's a research we are anxiously waiting to see its results. University of Zambia, for example, has now included us, the Department of Geology, as partners in this study, because we want it so. And then we have also embarked on the study of plants that have medicinal values. And we have narrowed down to some plants such as the moringa plant and the baobab and other plants that we have narrowed down. We have a team of researchers, about about 6 leading professors in the region, southern region, some based in South Africa, others based in Namibia, others here in Zambia, who've come together. And these are people who are known in the field of, in chemistry, in related fields to the research that we will embark on, which is with the Moringa plant. The Moringa plant is called as a magic tree. It's a magic plant. It has, so far, research has proved that it has the ability to help with animal life and animal productivity of milk. It has, as a matter of fact, I need to mention this. One of our leading professors, Professor Habauka Kwambwa, who's based in Namibia, has indicated that maybe we may be heading for a conclusion that could actually make Moringa be used for water purification in addition to or as a replacement to the things that we use currently.
Its recent addition to strategies meant to improve the institution's competitiveness is the unveiling of the Vision 2020 on May 22nd, 2018.
The Vision 2020 is an outline of a program that states where the university wants to be by 2020, December. What that simply tells in a nutshell is the university, its faculty, staff, and all the stakeholders identified 15 areas in which we want to grow from where we are right now to where we want to be by December 2020. So the component of the entire Vision 2020 has to do with a description of where we want the university to be. When people come in December 2020, we want them to come and see what we have described in the document, Vision 2020. I could liken it to anything that is done. You know how the government of Zambia has described what they want Zambia to be like by a certain time in the life of Zambia. What we want at Rusango is described in the 15 major strategic intents.
The strategic plan, spanning from 2016 to 2020, seeks to provide a consolidated vision that will inform the activities that Rusango University will vigorously pursue to attain the desired stipulated outcomes.
We are addressing 4 major resources. Number one, obviously, the obvious one is the financial resources. I am glad to report that Rusango University stands 100% as a self-supporting institution financially. We do not necessarily pay. We are not the lowest paying institution in Zambia. And so we have a fairly good financial base. Now, we are in our strategic document are intending to expand our financial base to where we will have what we are calling auxiliary enterprises. We want, as we teach our students on campus, to give examples of money-generating business operations we are doing. For example, we run a farm, and that farm has animals, it has crops. We operate a supermarket, of course, for the university and its constituency. We operate a cafeteria, which is like a restaurant where we sell food to our students. We operate, because we are heavy in building constructions, we have our own block making industry. So we are pushing in this. Our intention is actually to make sure that we continue to stand at a very solid financial resource base. I need to mention one area which we have embarked on very aggressively, and we're really hoping it, that is to see if we can provide what we call work programs for students. There are students who come to Rusang University with limited financial ability. For example, a student will say, I only have 50% of what you require for school fees. Can you help me? We have a program which we call work program. We pay students 10 kwacha per hour. When they enroll in that program, obviously they work some, no more than maybe 4 hours per day because they have to be in class. But during those 4 hours that they work, we pay 10 kwacha per hour. And this program is helping many students put themselves through school. What we are doing right now is I'm now appealing to the larger community of Zambia. What is better, to give a gift to a student or to give labor to a student, to give a job to a student? In this case, when a student works for their education, they will value it.
The document is a deliberate effort meant to organize Rusangu's energies around specific, measurable, and achievable goals to grow the university in all its facets. This was at a ceremony held at its Monze campus.
It is done.
While Rusangu University is a church institution operated under the philosophy of the mother body, Rusangu University is under severe competition from other providers of higher education in this nation. I start by that statement because the strategic plan is aimed at Rusangu University producing a product that when students are looking for a university, they will put us on the list of universities they have to go to. Rusangu University can be put out of its operations if Rusangu University does not continue to strive to higher heights that make the product they offer competitive with other products offered by other universities.
Southern African Indian Ocean Division Education Director, Dr. Muzechi Kadiakapita, was the guest of honor at the colorful unveiling ceremony.
It is a great honor for me to stand in your presence, to be part and parcel of the launching of this vision. I would want to say straight away that Rusangu is not a new place to me. In 2005, the person who was here, now late, Elder Mlundano, invited me from Malawi. Then I was the principal of Malawi Adventist College. He invited me to come see this campus and share ideas on how the two institutions could forge ahead together. We shared in so many issues, but one of the things that was so common to both institutions was lack of financial support. That was the common factor that brought us together. And so I visited this campus, went around. There wasn't really much to go around for at that time because I can't remember the building, but it was a building that was a library on one side. If you wanted to pull out a book, you could not bend between the shelves because by the time you do this way, you are hitting the other shelf here. You had to stand in that way to pull out a book. And then we went into a room which was for the, I think, Director of Finance. And behind the door was the lady's residence. That's how it started. And we went to the cafeteria. There were huge pots on three famous stones. We call them mafua, where I come from. And that's where cooking was done. But now, you look at Rusangu, from those humble beginnings, you stand to be amazed. In other words, I am trying to echo the speech that the chairman of the council has given, that this institution started humbly, but there is one who is not humble, one who is not generous, and is the one who is ever present and has guided this institution from those humble beginnings to what it is today. And so I am glad and very grateful to the administration and the committee that is responsible for organizing this particular function to include me to be part and parcel of the launch of this Vision 2020.
Dr. Kadia Kapita also expressed his concern over the African continent's slow development. His concern is that the continent has produced many renowned scholars and has abundant natural resources, but remains with little to show off for.
I was reading a certain article on the development of nations, and the author said something that I found very interesting. He was comparing Africa with the rest of the world. Why is it that Africa is still so poor up to this time? Of course, we have come forward with a plausible excuse to give ourselves comfort, and we blame the whites. That is what we are very capable of. Capitalism is the issue, so we will blame the British. South Africans will blame apartheid, and what have you. But this author says, look, Africa has produced marvelous scholars, individuals who are brilliant upstairs, economists, accountants, engineers, medical doctors, whoever. And some of them, unfortunately, flee to the developed countries. In other words, the argument is, we are not poor because we can't think. No, we are brilliant. But why are we poor? Maybe the issue of resources. But you know as I do that we have gold and silver and coal. We have oil in Africa, Nigeria being the fourth producer of oil in the world. We have Ivory Coast with so much of coffee and whatever. And then one wonders, say, no, but it's not the issue of resources. If we look at Switzerland, it produces milk, it produces chocolate, something that Africa may produce but not as palatable. And yet these items, the raw materials, come from Africa. We have produced engineers, University of Zambia, you can talk of University of Cape Town, you can talk of WITS, you can talk of, yes, prestigious universities producing engineers, but our roads are constructed by the Chinese. Yes, we have medical doctors, yes, but those who are politically connected and those who are rich don't go to an African hospital. They don't go to Cape Town, where human heart transplantation was done. They go to India, they go to Europe. So the issue is not that we are not brilliant. The issue is not that we don't have raw materials. No, not at all. Japan was completely destroyed at the end of the Second World War. But now, go anywhere, at least in the Western Europe and in Africa, You have Toyota, you have Mazda, you have... Talk about it.
Yes, sir.
What is the problem? That's the question. Our biggest challenge is attitude.
Yes, sir.
Towards work. Attitude. And so the success of this strategic plan partly depends on the attitude we have towards it.
Rusangu University Vice Chancellor Dr. Pardon Mwanza was on hand to give a further insight into the Vision 2020.
This document has outlined 15 areas in which the university will rally its financial resources, its human resources, its physical resources, its information resources to get to where we will say we are growing. Those areas are outlined. Our governance, organization, and administration is aiming at improving so that in our administration, we are open and willing to listen and create a better university. Our spirituality on campus. As a spiritual entity, our chair articulated our origins. Other universities will offer the products they have. Ours has to have the spiritual component equally developed. Number three, programs of study have to be improved and continuously meet the expected standards. Number four, student enrollment. Number five, faculty and staff employment and development. Finances, library services, academic, intellectual, and financial record policies, public relations, student life and services, campus building and appearance, auxiliary enterprises, security on campus, and the creation ultimately of what we want to come and see as the city of Rusangu, taking into account the efforts from every corner, including our auxiliary enterprises.
The University Council, through its chairperson, Dr. Harrison Akombwa, also added its voice.
Rusangu is going to continue growing and growing. There's somebody who is steering this ship. There's somebody who is steering the vision. Leaders will come and go, but there is one who does not go. He is the same all the time. And he is here to bless us to the extent that we are willing to be used by him. To that extent, he will honor himself. And as members of council, as members of staff and faculty, we are part of that small group that the Lord would like to use at this time. And I want to thank management for boldly stepping out to put something together that will help us move forward. When this vision is completed that we are launching today, this Rusangu will not be what we see today. Greater things are going to be done. I'm happy to announce as chair of council that in our sitting today, we are going to make some decisions that will bring about change that will be seen tomorrow, because Rusangu is going forward, and welcome to be part of that vision.
The Seventh-day Adventist Church Run University continues to strive to remain relevant to the needs of industry with an added value of Christian teachings.
You will grow in so many ways when you come to Rusangu University, spiritually, academically. It's perfect, it's excellent.
So far, it's good. I can't complain. I'm enjoying it here.
As a Christian university, Rusangu exists principally for academic excellence, intimately intertwined with God-centered Christian values. The intimate union of intellectual pursuit and a commitment to Christian principles sets Rusangu University apart as a model institution that ultimately produces graduates who have a holistic worldview.